Hello and welcome to this short video. My name is Kennedy Ogutu, working for Palladium under Kenya GEMIS project. In this video, I'm going to take you through the process of completing a drug order encounter. To do so, provide username and password and ensure the user logging in is a provider for them to offer services to a client. Once logged in, the system will navigate you to the home page. Click on home. Once done, there are two ways of accessing drug prescriptions. The first one, click on the drug prescriptions application. Once done, search for the patient using either the name or the patient ID. You can start typing the first three characters of the name and a list of matching patients will be generated for you. Click the right patient. Once done, the system will navigate you to the drug prescriptions. The second option of accessing drug prescriptions is through the clinician application. Click on the clinician application under home. Once you're done, search for the patient using either the patient name or the ID. When the list is populated for you, select on the patient you want to update drug orders for and click on that patient. Once done, the system will navigate you to the patient dashboard and open for you the patient file. Ensure the client is ART and also ensure that the patient is checked in. Remember, this is a patient on workflow and was checked in at the triage level. To access drug orders, on the right side of the screen under Provider Action Panel, click on Drug Orders link. Once done, the system will navigate you to drug prescription. By default, the active orders page will be loaded. As you can see, this client doesn't have any active orders that has been done for her. Prescribe standard ARV regimen for this particular client. Click on standard regimen order tab, where you'll find the current regimen the client is on will be displayed for you. For my case, my client is on TDF, 3TC and DTG. To dispense drugs this particular regimen to the client, click on the prescribe regimen button to load for you the standard regimen page. Select the date from the calendar menu. Program, regimen line and regimen will be pre-populated for you. The drugs, the dosage and units will also be pre-populated for you. Frequency, quantity and units will also be populated for you. But these ones are not cast on stone. You can always change if any case the dosage has changed and even the units. If the frequencies have changed, you can always click on the down arrow to display the line list. Select the correct one. You can change the quantity if what is populated is not correct, and then the units. Enter the duration for which the drugs have been prescribed and then the units. The additional information you can always type in the free text area. Once done and you're sure that you've done the correct entries, click on Order Regimen tab. If any case you want to cancel this particular drug order, you can click on Cancel. For my case, I'll click on Order Regimen. You'll be notified that the drug order was saved successfully. Once done, drug order you've just done for the standard regimen will be displayed under Active Orders. If you'd want to prescribe other drugs other than the standard regimen, you click on Other Drug Orders. Select it from the calendar menu. And then under new order form, type the name of the drug you'd want to dispense. A list will be populated for you. Select the correct drug, enter the dosage, units, frequency, and the route that will be used to administer the drug. If there are any reason or additional information, you can type in the free text area, the duration for which the drug is prescribed, the units. You can add any additional information not covered, the quantity that has been dispensed, and the units. Once done, the add button will be activated and displayed in green, and the cancel button in any case you want to cancel this particular drug order. In my case, I'm sure of the entries I've done, and I will click add button. Once done, the unsaved drug orders will be displayed, and the number of unsaved drug orders. This one is one, that is why one is in bracket. In any case you have more than one, total number will be displayed in the bracket. You can edit this particular drug order by clicking on the pencil icon, or you can cancel it. You can as well click on the red button to discard this particular drug order. If any case you're sure of the order that you've done, you'll be signing this particular drug order and saving. Click on the sign and save if you're sure. as for my case. Once you're done, the drug order that you've done will be displayed under other drug orders. At this particular time, there are actions that can be taken. You can dispense the drugs for a facility that doesn't have ADT. If a facility has got ADT, meaning that the pharmacist is the one who will be prescribing the drugs, then you click on the post prescriptions to ADT button on the left side of the screen. When you click post prescriptions to ADT, being that Kenya MR is interoperable via the interoperability layer to ADT, when you click these particular prescriptions will be sent to ADT, whereby the pharmacist will receive, dispense the drug, and the message will come back to Kenya MR. If any case the facility is not having ADT, you click on dispense. The edit buttons can be used to edit the prescriptions if any case changes are going to be made. In my case, I did the correct prescriptions and I will go ahead and dispense both the standard regimen orders and other drug orders by clicking on dispense. Once done, under active orders, there'll be none that is there under standard regimen because I've already dispensed it. We'll go ahead and dispense other drug orders too by clicking on the button. The unsafe drug orders will be displayed. If any case I want to discontinue or I want to edit or close. For my case, I'm not editing any or I'm discarding this particular drug order. I will sign and save. Once done under active orders, you will not see any active orders because we have already done the dispensing. To confirm this, when you come to past drug orders, the prescriptions that you've done will be displayed under past drug orders. Once done with the drug prescriptions, you can close patient chat. And that marks the end of this presentation. For further information on this and more, please refer to our online training resources on the link provided, or you can call us on our toll-free service desk line on the number provided. I hope you have enjoyed this tutorial. Thank you.